Hello, how are you? I hope you're having a lovely day. So I wanted to come and share something that was actually really valuable to me about 6 months ago. And it was a piece of advice or a way of looking at a situation that was given to me by my life coach. And so I'll put it in context. I'll tell you the kind of the story that this originated from. So in January, my mum and my fiance went skiing in Colorado, in the United States. And within about a day or two of being there, Friedel, who's my fiance, was just saying to me, "Oh my God, we've got to do ski season. Like, this is amazing." And he'd never seen the snow before. And so he was, so first time snowboarding, absolutely loving his life. And he was just saying, "We've got to do ski season. This is amazing. This is the best thing ever." And so he was job hunting for the following year's ski season. And when he said this to me, I was like, "Yeah, you know what? I've always wanted to do a ski season. Like, this is something that I could totally do. You know, I remember as in, yeah, I've always wanted to do a ski season." And I had an appointment by on the phone with my life coach anyway during that trip, and I can't remember saying to her, "You know, look, like Frida really wants to do a ski season, and I've always really wanted to do one, and you know, I think it'd be awesome." But I told her something just wasn't sitting right for some reason. Something just didn't feel right about it. And she said, "Okay, well, what would the day-to-day of a ski season look like for you?" And I said, "Well, we would need to live somewhere, and it's like we're in Aspen, so it's incredibly expensive. So we'd probably need to live in like share accommodation, you know, with other people. We'd need to have jobs to support ourselves to live there and to eat there, and it'd probably look like two or three different jobs because I spoke to a few people that were working like at the snow ski shops or restaurants or bars, and they all had a few jobs to support themselves. Then I said, you know, we'd probably be going out a lot, like 5 or 6 nights a week. We'd be meeting people, you know, backpackers, people with accents I probably wouldn't be able to understand. Like, just, you know, we'd be in that environment of just, you know, travelers and backpackers, and we'd be having the conversations that you do when you're traveling. You know, it's like, "Hey, who are you? Where are you from? What's your story? What are you doing here?" And after I said that, she just said to me, "Okay, so does the day-to-day of what that looks like align with you? Does it feel right for you?" And I realized that it really didn't. You know, just because you've always wanted to do something and you never had the chance to do it doesn't mean you should do it now. You know, just because something's right for the 23-year-old you does not mean that it's right for the 29-year-old you, in my case. Because yeah, when I was in my early 20s, I would have jumped at this. And I've had lots of beautiful experiences that were very similar to this. You know, I did a student exchange in California for 12 months. I worked in the Greek islands for a summer, worked on super yachts in the south of France for a little while, and I had such beautiful, rich experiences. And by rich, I mean, you know, nourishing for the soul and things that just light you up. And this is also an experience I wanted to have as you know, in my early 20s. But when I sat back and realized what the day-to-day of that experience would look like, particularly for me now, I realized that it just wasn't right anymore. It wasn't right for me, because what is right for me now is, you know, I have a home, and I want to be in my home. I love watering my lawn. Like, I want to start to grow my own veggies. You know, I want to get a dog. I'd love investing my time and energy in having a beautiful anchor point in my home. And the Penny in her early 20s didn't want that. You know, she wanted to have bare feet and dirty hair and no money and no plans and a backpack on her back, and that's a beautiful existence for the time that it was right for me. But that existence isn't right for me anymore, and to an extent, that is what a ski season would have looked like. So I just thought that that was such an interesting way of looking at something, because what I, can you hear the ambulance in the background? Sorry. What I kind of saw a ski season being from the outside is, oh, you know, like being in winter, having beautiful winter clothes, you know, having hot chocolates and mulled wine by the fire, and just being all snug and cozy and watching movies for 6 months. Like, that would have been my, that's like, you know, on the outside, that's what a ski season looks like. looks like hot chocolates, and it looks like snow angels, and it looks like skiing on the slopes. But as soon as you take that away, the facade away, and you dig underneath it a little bit more, and you see what the day-to-day would actually be, working a few jobs and living in share accommodation with backpackers and going out to bars 5 or 6 nights a week and meeting travelers just isn't my idea of truth anymore. And so, yeah, that one way of looking at something really helped me to make a decision that I might have otherwise gone the other way on. I mean, I don't know, it's September right now. Like, I could have easily been saving right now for a freaking ski season in Aspen 2018. But, you know, just because she pointed that out to me, what does the day-to-day of that look like? Yeah, really brought me home to, like, what is true for me and what's right. So I just thought it was a really great way of looking at a situation, and I'm hoping maybe you can relate to it as well or bring that into your own life. You know, there's something that you're looking at, wondering about, should I do this? You know, forget what it's going to look like on the outside, you know, because snow angels and skiing and really good hats is what a ski season looks like on Instagram. but you've got to be happy with the day-to-day of it as well. You know, the day-to-day has got to match and align just as much with how it looks on the outside. So it's really useful to me, so I just wanted to pass it on to you as well. Yeah, but thank you for watching. I hope you're having a beautiful day wherever you are, and I'll see you next time. Bye.